what's recommended and finding that as this is going on longer and even with more, you know, more contagion variants, despite being vaccinated, you know, the emotional burden and the stress that has really fallen onto frontier health workers, and it's largely unspoken about.
I can't imagine how you've managed to do this for 22 months, Jasmine.
Yeah, I mean, I have wonderful friends, but again, very limited because I don't want to expose my circle wider. So just the testing's pretty locked down, and thankfully we still not have COVID, but we just take it day by day as much as we can and the best resources possible. But it's been difficult.
I can certainly imagine. Jasmine, stay with us. Dr. Stratman, how familiar is a story like Jasmine's?
I think Jasmine's story is very familiar to a lot of us. We know that a lot of women have had to do the double shift, and that's exactly what we call the paper. We also know that there's been lots of less opportunities for women to get together to sort of share their experience. And one of the things that came out of this paper is we actually started a women's discussion group so that women could meet over Zoom, discuss what they were feeling, but also to have some learning opportunities to expand their possibility of taking on leadership positions in the future. So it was both a support and an education group, and the women that have attended so far have found this very useful. And that's sort of maybe one of the silver linings, is that this has sort of created a little bit of community amongst women physicians who are feeling the same things, and maybe feeling things differently than their male counterparts because of the more burden from doing the double shift.
And Jasmine, for you, is there any respite at all in being able to talk this over with your female colleagues?
Yeah, certainly even my male colleagues are quite supportive. And just the other point is that as this goes on longer, burnout is happening amongst physicians, maybe more so disproportionately towards female physicians for exactly what we're talking about here today. But it seems like the tempers are on the rise, and what really is needed is that sense of solidarity and unity between all of us, community-wise, you know, country-wise, worldwide, but that we are still all in this together. I feel that dropped off somewhere through the pandemic, and people are arguing more, and if that's happening in the hospital and in our own personal lives, and I would like to see that rhetoric brought back in a compassionate environment that we can still be on each other and be supportive emotionally. So I'm glad to hear that things like this program for female physicians is occurring.
And Professor Smith is